Have you ever experienced that in spite of going for regular walks, doing your exercises in the gym, doing yoga, and even playing your favorite sport, your clothes do become loose, but that needle on the wing scale refuses to budge?
And have you ever noticed two people of the same gender, same age, same height, and both having the same weight? But when you look at them, they look so different. One might be very fit and the other might look very heavy and even obese. This is because if we compare an equal weight of muscle tissue and fat tissue, we will observe that muscle tissue occupies much less volume compared to the fat tissue of the same weight.
So let's understand the science behind our body composition.
Welcome to Mango Do It. I'm Simran.
And I'm Sanjay. Our body composition is the measure of the percentage of fat, water, bone and muscle in our body. We must regularly measure these to ensure our overall health.
These can be easily monitored at home using a body composition scale. This scale tells us our weight, our BMI, our visceral fat, our fat percentage, our muscle, our resting metabolism, and also our relative body age.
There are several body composition scales available in the market and online. We have been using an Omron scale since a few years. It is designed for the family and comes with a multi-user mode. We only have to set the age, height, and gender once, and the machine automatically recognizes the user once he or she steps on the scale.
These days, the scale available are more user-friendly with an advanced system that can be connected to an app on your mobile phones or a wrist tracker, both in Android and iOS systems. The price range starts from 1500 and goes up to 15,000. Some well-known brands are Actifit, Tanita, Omron Karada, Lifetron, and some wrist trackers are Fitbit, Opta, Samsung. The list is endless. We are posting a few links in the description box for you to explore.
Let's understand these parameters one by one and why it is important for us to keep them in check.
The first parameter is BMI, or body mass index. It is the measure of body fat that is based on the weight and height of adult men and women. BMI is measured in kilograms per meter square. If the score is less than 18.5, then a person is underweight. 18.5 to 24.9 indicates normal, 25 to 29.9 shows overweight, and 30 or greater indicates that a person is obese.
The second parameter is visceral fat. It is the kind of fat that surrounds our vital organs like liver, stomach, intestines. It increases the risk of cardiovascular diseases and other chronic diseases.
So now you must be wondering whether belly fat is visceral fat. Belly fat is not necessarily visceral fat. Belly fat is just subcutaneous fat which is stored beneath our skin. It's the same kind of fat which can even get stored in our arms or in our legs. The only way to know the exact visceral fat is only by an MRI or a CT scan. But these body composition scales do give us a fair amount of idea.
There is an easy way to tell if you are at risk from visceral fat by measuring your waistline. According to Harvard Health, if you are a woman and your waist is more than 35 inches, or if you are a man and your waist is more than 40 inches, in that case, you are at risk from visceral fat.
The third most important parameter that should be kept in check is our resting metabolic rate and our basal metabolic rate.
RMR is the measure of how many calories you burn in a state of rest, may it be sitting on the couch or watching TV, etc.
And BMR is the energy needed for all the vital organs of our body to perform their functions, such as the heart, the lungs, the nervous system, the kidneys, and so on. For a high RMR, we need low fat percentage and we need more of lean muscle mass.
And to increase your lean muscle mass, you need to have a good fitness regime. In your fitness regime, along with your cardio, also add weight training at least 3 to 5 times a week.
See, by weight training, we don't mean just lifting weights. Even yoga, when you work with your body weight, that also really builds up muscle.
You must eat frequent meals. Eating every 3 hourly in small portions is very good for enhancing your RMR.
So when our RMR is more, our body continues to burn calories even when we are sleeping.
And even after exercising, our bodies keep burning calories throughout the day.
So more lean muscles in our body, lower fat percentage, and low risk of cardiovascular or any chronic ailments.
But what causes the RMR to decrease?
As we age, as early as 20, our body starts to lose 2 to 3% of our lean muscle every decade.
So it is very important to start weight training and other exercises to build up your muscles at an early age.
In fact, in women, the thyroid and hormone production starts slowing down after 40. And this has a drastic effect on our RMR.
So to have a good RMR,
eat small healthy meals every 3 hourly,
exercise your muscles,
drink lots of water,
and get plenty of rest. The fourth essential parameter is the body fat percentage.
It is the total mass of fat divided by the total body mass multiplied by 100.
The total fat includes essential body fat and storage fat.
And essential body fat is necessary to maintain life. Body fat percentage categories: athletes, women 14 to 20%, men 6 to 13%, fitness, women 21 to 24%, men 14 to 17%. Acceptable range for women is 25 to 31%, and for men 18 to 25%. Obese fat percentage is more than 32% in women and more than 25% in men.
The fifth important parameter is our body age or biological age. It is based on our health and fitness level.
Unlike our chronological age, our body age depends upon our lifestyle and health factors.
A 30-year-old who does not take care of his health and fitness level might have the body age of a 40-year-old.
And a 50-year-old conscious person who eats healthy and does regular exercises might have a body of a 40-year-old. So checking your weight regularly on an ordinary weighing scale is not enough. You need to keep various other parameters in check to ensure that you're healthy. To sum up, these are body mass index, visceral fat, resting and basal metabolic rate, body fat percentage, body age.
A body mass composition scale is a must. In case you don't have one, invest in one now. Take care of yourself. Be safe. Bye-bye.